What's wrong?
Oh, it's nothing.
Wait, did you get your nails done?
Oh my gosh, how did you know? Don't they look so good?
Does anyone have a pencil I can borrow?
Oh yeah, I do. Here you go.
Why the fuck are you handing me the pencil like that?
You know what, my bad. Just take the fucking pencil.
What are you doing?
Oh, you know, just writing out an email.
It kind of sounds like you're pressing random letters on your keyboard.
Well, I'm not.
Then show me your screen.
I don't really think that's necessary.
That's what I fucking thought.
You know, I could be an ASM artist with these nails.
Yeah, sure.
No, seriously, look.
Can you maybe actually help with the project?
Yeah, fine, whatever.
Who knows the answer?
Oh, I do!
Do you need to go to the nurse? Is there something wrong with your arm?
No.
Then why are you holding your hand backwards?
I don't have any red flags, bitch. If anything, my red flags are just like fun facts about myself. I'm not even a vegan. You're weird as fuck. Emotionally unavailable. And who said that? You, bitch. Okay.
So I started playing this new game with guys I'm talking to. The game is called How Unhinged Can I Be Before You Block Me? And essentially the way that the game works is I'll add guys that I've matched with on dating apps on Snapchat and then act completely unhinged and see how long it takes for them to either lose interest or just block me. For example, the other day this guy snapped me a picture of him at the gym and he was like,
"Working on my pecs."
And he had some nice man titties. So this is what I sent him back. Do you want to know what his response back was? "Come get some." Then yesterday he sent me a picture of his bicep. And I sent him this picture of the eye emoji and I was like, "Oh." And he was like,
"Yeah."
And I'm assuming he thought I was gonna say something like really flirty. But instead I wrote back in all caps, "I want to bite your arm." Do you want to know what his response was?
"Come do it then."
Right now I feel like nothing's off the table. Because every guy is just like,
"Oh yeah."
Whenever I tell you bitches that I'm talking to someone or I went on a date with someone, I always see a comment that's like, "How is Spencer talking to someone and I'm not?" Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not, you know, fuck a dime in this bitch! It's time for the Tilly Scream! Let me teach you all a little lesson. I pull guys because I don't mind not being in a relationship. Having a relationship would be nice, but do I need a relationship? Absolutely fucking not. I'm not chasing a man who doesn't act like he wants me. For example, last night a guy messaged me at 11 p.m. after we had been talking back and forth, and he said, "Night." Not good night, not sweet dreams. So this was my reply. After seeing that photo, he said,
"That was mean."
So I sent him this.
"Next time, say good night." Yeah, and I did flip you off because of that.
You want to know what he messaged me back? "Have a good night." And then this morning, you want to know what he messaged me? "Morning, beautiful. I know my worth. Not relying on men to add value to my life. That is how I pull."
Sometimes I forget that like I have a social media platform. I also forget that the guys I'm talking to will like see my TikToks of me talking shit about them and then they'll like block me. Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream.
So in the past 2 weeks, I've made 2 videos about 2 guys I've been talking to. One video was about how I like playing a game where I'm unhinged with men. An example of me being unhinged is when guy number one sent me a picture of him at the gym saying,
"Working out my pecs."
And I sent him this video. The second video I'm talking about was from yesterday, where I told you all about this guy I was talking to. Turns out him and his boyfriend broke up literally a month ago, and the only reason he called me was to vent to me about his ex, which in turn led to me hanging up and him texting me,
"Down to fuck?"
In both of these videos, I'm talking about very specific individuals. And I never really think to myself before posting,
"Oh, he's gonna see this."
Until this morning, I woke up with a message from both of them on Snapchat. And do you want to know what each of them individually messaged me? A link to the TikTok video I made about them. And when I tried to respond back, I had already been unadded. So like, I couldn't even say anything. You know what? I honestly, like, I don't give a fuck. If they saw those TikToks, they'll definitely see this one. So let me give you both a final farewell. Guy number one, you only
me ever message me pics of you at the gym or at the club. You're boring. And I'm not sorry I used you to see how long I could be unhinged for. Guy number two. You literally called me to vent about your ex-boyfriend that you broke up with
a month ago.
Either way, you've both done me a favor. And you both can kick rocks, bitch.
What do you guys want to do tomorrow?
I mean, we can go to the Pride Parade.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
Yeah, for you guys.
What's that supposed to mean?
I just don't get why they have to be all up in your face with rainbows and the whole gay thing.
The gay thing?
Bitch, I'm about to get all up in your face.
Look, I don't care if people are gay. For God's sakes, my girlfriend's best friend is gay. I just prefer not to see stuff like that.
Has it ever crossed your mind that you think it's all in your face because in the past it wasn't?
What do you mean by that?
In the past, if gay people were out and proud, they'd be killed. So maybe you think it's all in your face because you're just not used to it. On top of that, I could say the same exact thing about straight people.
In what way?
All you see in movies and TV shows are straight couples. And if there are gay characters, they're usually left in the background. And let's also not forget straight people who constantly make out in public.
Bet you don't notice or care about that.
Gayness isn't being shoved in your face. It's just happening in real time and you're noticing it because gay people are finally somewhat comfortable being themselves.
Also, I don't see any laws putting the lives of straight people at risk. What about gay people?
Well, you're concerned about whether or not a gay couple is gonna kiss in front of you. We're concerned about our rights, our well-being, and our lives.
I'm sorry. I didn't really think about all of that until now. Thank you for telling me.
You're welcome. But if I have to repeat this shit again, I promise you I will paint my own custom rainbow flag and the red paint will be your fucking blow.
Okay, so what time do we have to wake up for the parade tomorrow?
So yesterday I went out with my friends for Pride Month. And while we were out, my friend Emmy and her partner wanted to take like cute little couple pics. I was sitting next to them while these photos were being taken. And I didn't know that our friend who was taking the photos would also include me in the photos.
But guys,
like guys. When I tell you that, like, this is my vibe during Pride Month, I'm just so happy for you, and I'm so happy you're in a happy relationship. Happy Pride or whatever.
7 weeks before we
you
had
believe
this
men.
Thing. Seven
in
weeks.
2020.
I'm not gonna lie.
You believe
I
men.
Never in my life have I ever had to call my mother to have her get me into a club until last night. And I'm not gonna lie.
She ate.
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the daily scream. So in case you guys didn't know, I did have my wallet stolen. However, I do have my temporary license that I printed off the DMV website until my actual ID gets here. Anyways, yesterday was the Pride Parade in LA. Now, you'd assume if you had an official document from the DMV website saying that you're 21, you wouldn't have any problems getting into places. But wrong! I was not being let in anywhere yesterday. Like,
at fucking all.
Every place I went to needed like a physical photo ID. Finally, I was like, fuck this. And I went to the actual Pride event where they have performers and dancers. Now, in order to purchase and drink there, I needed a wristband that said I was 21. And Lord, my mom came in fucking clutch. I'm online to get the 21 plus wristband. I show them my temporary ID. And they ended up having to get head of security because they didn't know what to do. Head of security comes over. He starts asking me all of these fucking questions. First question was my birthday, where I was born, my current address, my old address when I lived in New Jersey. And finally, I was like, you know what? Do you want to just talk to my mom? I call my mom, hand my phone to head of security. He starts talking to her, and not even 5 seconds later, I got a fucking wristband. I looked at him and I was like, what did she say to you? And he goes,
I know you're 21 because this is what your mom told me on the phone.
I wish I could tell you that he wasn't 21 because I don't want him drinking at 3 p.m., but the pain I endured during childbirth 21 years ago says otherwise. Like, she ate that up. Mom, you ate that. And that's what I like to call an ally.
Hey, what's up?
I have something I have to tell you.
Okay.
You know that girl, Jessica, you told me you got a bad feeling from?
Yeah.
So she's actually a bitch. Hello?
I fucking knew it.
Okay, slow down, because you literally had no reason not to like her.
Actually, I had every reason.
And those were?
I told you, I got a weird feeling from her, and my intuition is always right.
But you only hung out with her one time.
And, as I said, my bestie intuition is never wrong. What does she do anyways?
She invited me to hang out with her in the sky.
Wait, let me guess.
The entire time you were all together, she treated you differently and was trying to, like, show off in front of him.
Yes! She was literally being a bitch to me and acting like she was better than me.
I knew it! This is why I always tell you to listen to my bestie instincts.
I know, but how did you even know?
When we first met her, I thought she was pretty cool, but the longer I was around her, the more off I felt about her.
I should have listened to you.
Well, at least you know better for next time, but in the meanwhile, did you want to get back at her? I was thinking we could, like, fill her locker with shaving cream.
I was actually just gonna—
Or we can sneak into her house in the middle of the night and shave her head.
Bestie, we don't have to do all of that.
Wait. Or we can lick Jolly Ranchers and stick them onto her windshield so the glass on her car breaks.
Bestie! I was just gonna stop talking to her.
Fine, be boring, but if you change your mind, I have a whole bunch of other shit we can do too.
Okay, yeah, I'll let you know.
Didn't I do it for you? Why don't I do it for you? Why won't you do it for me?
Hey!
Hey!
How are you feeling?
I'm okay.
Do you need—
What the fuck is going on?
What's happening? I don't like this! I'm just fucking with you. Hey, do you think it's kicked in yet?
I'm not really sure.
Hey, do you think it's kicked in yet?
You already asked me that.
Asked you what? Oh, hey, do you think it's kicked in yet?
Why do you keep repeating yourself?
I'm not repeating myself. Do you think it's kicked in yet?
This isn't funny.
Sorry. Hey, how are you feeling?
Pretty good. Why?
Okay, just make sure whatever you do, just don't look in the mirror.
Why?
Because of the spiders! The spiders!
What spiders? Wait, where? What
spiders? Stop! Where
are the spiders?
Oh, calm down. I'm just fucking with you.
You're so brave. What do you mean?
Did you test it before using it?
No.
Then for all we know, you could end up in like an eternal trip for the rest of your life and never recover. Or you can just end up fucking dead.
What the fuck?
What's that smell?
What smell?
It smells like burning hair.
Well, we are in hell, so I wouldn't be so—
Oh my god! What is it? Is there something on my face?
No, Bessie. You look fine.
And then I was like, no, I don't want to scrub in between your hooves.
And I would have done the same thing.
You two, get back to work.
Really, Satan?
Really?
Come on, it's Pride Month.
Yeah, can we have like a little time off work?
Wait, you guys are gay?
How do you think we ended up here?
I love the gays.
Really?
Yeah, you guys really should have told me sooner. Come on. And after I found out that he cheated on me, I was like, oh, hell no! No pun intended. So I sent his ass to the lakes of Tartarus where he can burn for the rest of eternity.
You're such a fucking girl boss. I wish I could send my ex there. Yeah, and he'd fucking deserve it. You wanna talk about cheaters? Let's talk about him.
What's your ex's name?
Steve Johnson.
Oh, yep, I see him. He is right here. He was on level 4 filing down goat hooves, but— Oops, my finger slipped.
Where is he now?
He's burning in the lakes of Tartarus with my ex. I'm sure they'll be great together.
Satan, you are so bad. And they say chivalry is dead.
Stop it.
Bitch, I really need to start researching movies before I go see them. Because yesterday I went to go see the new animated Spider-Man movie, and I have never been more confused in my life. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So yesterday I went to the movie theater with a few friends to see the new Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. And bitch, I have never been more fucking lost in my life. During the movie, I kept like whispering to my friends and asking them questions. Cause in the movie, the characters kept mentioning and talking about things as if the audience was like already supposed to know what they were talking about. The characters were also acting like they already knew each other. After the movie, I looked at my friends and I was like, guys, that was so fucking confusing. And they were like, what do you mean? And I was telling them that I felt like I was missing like so much information. And then one of my friends asked me if I saw the first movie. Bitch, I was under the impression that that was the first movie. Bitch, watching that movie felt like I was watching Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2 without seeing any other Harry Potter movies prior. I genuinely was sitting through that whole movie just like trying to put the pieces together. And I was literally sitting there like, damn, the directors of this movie fucking suck. No, bitch, I'm just a fucking dumbass and didn't know that there was a movie I was supposed to watch before that one. So yeah, I recommend if you're gonna go see the new Spider-Man movie, make sure you watch the first one, because otherwise it's like really fucking confusing. Whoever works in the kitchen at the Brandy Melville Cafe, they are out to fucking get me. And this isn't a conspiracy. It is the
god awful truth.
Everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So yeah, I went to the Brandy Melville Cafe the other day. I went because I was hungry, it was open, it was there. I'm sorry. But if it makes you feel any better, karma got me. I go to the Brandy Melville Cafe, I order a fucking sandwich. That's all I wanted, a fucking sandwich. I don't know who the fuck was working in that kitchen, but when I got my fucking sandwich, bitch, it was drenched in chili olive oil. Like literal chili infused olive oil. And I'm not the type of person to like bring food back. Bitch, there could have been a dead rat and a cockroach in my sandwich. But the anxiety I would get handing that sandwich back to a worker, not worth it. So yeah, I did eat that. I did eat that chili olive oil soaked sandwich.
The bread
was literally so soggy that when I picked up the bread, it was supposed to be toasted. Bitch, when I picked it up, it was limp. I could have wrung out that fucking sandwich, bitch. But yeah, I ate it, whatever.
I was hungry, okay? I was hungry!
Anyways, I shouldn't have eaten that sandwich because the things it did to my stomach are unspeakable. Guys, I understand why everybody who shops at Brandy Melville is so fucking skinny. It's because if they eat at the Brandy Melville Cafe, they will literally shit out everything in their body. Literally, while I was on the toilet, I was like, did this bitch put laxatives in my food? But hey, on the plus side, at least now I could probably fit into a Brandy Melville extra small t-shirt.
It's Pride Month, bitch. Fuck it. Tell me what gay I am. I want to know. So like, is this your way of calling me skinny or what?
These right here? These right fucking here? Hell no. Hell fucking no. I'm terrified. We are living in the Matrix. They invented Apple glasses and the way they work is by tracking your eye movement. Bitch, we are entering Terminator 3. Oh my god, guys. These would put a medieval child into a coma. Mind you, 20 years ago, they only had fucking flip phones. Now we have this shit on the market?
No.
AI is taking over the world. We're all doomed. I'm saving all of my money, making a bunker, and living underground. What? No.
Some of you bitches in the comment section of one of my recent videos had the audacity to say that I'm weird for being afraid of the new Apple Vision Pros. Bitch, I have done a lot of weird shit in my day. Being afraid of these motherfuckers
is not one of them.
You're the weird one, bitch. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream.
You mean to tell me you aren't the least bit concerned that there's now technology being released to the public that can track your eye movement? Bitch, have you not seen the movie Ready Player One? Bitch, have you not seen Terminator? Bitch, have you not seen The Matrix? It's giving mind control. It's giving this scene from the SpongeBob movie. Not to mention, AI has gone mainstream this year. And you guys are saying that I'm weird for being afraid of new technology being released to the public? This is quite literally the start of every world-ending movie. Humans invent AI. The technology evolves too quickly. That technology then becomes conscious, sentient beings.
And they take over the world.
Like, bitch, I have every right to say that I want to build a bunker and live underground. If you aren't the least bit concerned about this shit, you're weird! Weirdo, weirdo, you're weird!
He's a 7, but he wants you to call him daddy.
He's a 10 in my eyes, like.
Yeah, I said it. What about it, bitch? Not a single lie was told. Hey girl, I'm really happy they went with the dress I picked out for you. Don't tell your mom I'm telling you, but at one point she wanted to bury you in this old ass pilgrim dress, and I was like, nah, that is not gonna work, because if she is buried in that, she will claw her way out of the grave and kill us both. You're welcome, bitch. Also, hold on, they fucked up your lipstick a bit, and I'm not having my number one bitch looking fucked up at her own funeral. So then Todd was telling me about that girl, Vanessa, you know, the bitch I fucking
hate. Excuse me, you've been up here for 30 minutes. Can we please pay our respects now?
Yeah, hi, excuse me, bitch. I'm not done talking to my bestie. Get in line and wait like everybody else.
Can you believe people, bestie? Anyways, you know Todd, right? So Todd's cousin got lice from Vanessa.
Boo!
Really? Nothing? Damn, bitch. I was checking to make sure you weren't faking being dead and shit, but I guess you really are dead. You better save me a seat next to the hottest, sexiest man up in heaven, because if you don't, bitch, when I walk in through those pearly gates, we're gonna have some beef. I love you, girl. Also, I hope you don't mind, but I did need a new laptop, so I just took yours since you're like dead and everything.
I'm gonna kill you.
So today I woke up bright and early because I had a meeting with an acting agency. I was cleaning, I had my hair up in a bun, I did some laundry, and around 10 a.m. I went to go take a shower so I could look semi-presentable in my meeting. I go to start the water to warm up my shower.
And guess what?
The water wasn't fucking running! So then I was like, I wonder if my complex sent out an email about this. I go check my email, and this is what I see. 10:01 a.m. Dear residents, we have an unexpected plumbing emergency that requires the water to be shut off immediately. The shutoff may last up to 4 hours. We will send out an updated notification once the water is turned back on. We sincerely apologize for the inconvenience. And they said we'd have water in 4 hours? 5 fucking hours ago! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know fucking terminus, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! Now, usually I wouldn't give two fucks if I had to wait to shower, except as I mentioned earlier,
I had a fucking meeting with an acting agency!
And just to show you what I mean when I say I literally have no running water right now, lo and behold, I had this meeting. I didn't know what to do because it was a fucking acting agency. Bitch, do you want to know how I showed up to this meeting? Like fucking this! That is how I showed up to the meeting because I had no way of fixing my god-awful hair. Luckily, I have a decent personality, so I hope my personality made up for what I lacked in my physical appearance. But really, bitch! I don't know if I'll ever hear from this agency again. I really hope they overlook that bad fucking hair day. But are you fucking kidding me? The one day. The one fucking day! I have a meeting with an acting agency. That's the day a main waterline bursts in my fucking apartment complex! So if you missed it, yesterday I had a meeting with an acting agency. At the meeting, I looked like this because I had no running water for 6 hours and I couldn't shower. Anyways, a lot of you guys have been asking me. Tell us if they reach back out. Tell us if they contact you again. Tell us if they want to work with you. And guess what, bitch? They want to work with me! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, well, you know a fucking diamond L! It's time for the Daily Scream! So after my meeting with this acting agency, I was fully under the impression that I fumbled the bag, but I guess I didn't. They actually contacted me yesterday later in the afternoon saying they wanted to work with me. They spoke with me. I told them that I was sorry for the way that I looked in the meeting. And they said that they didn't care how I looked at all because they were more so looking at my personality. And they then went on to tell me that they loved me! I don't really know what's gonna happen moving forward from here. But essentially for right now, they gave me a list of things that they want me to do before moving forward with anything. I wish I could tell you more, but that's genuinely all the information I currently have right now. But I am so fucking happy that they did not care about the way that I looked. They actually told me the way I presented myself was hilarious, and they enjoyed talking to me because I know how to keep a conversation going. So let's just keep our fingers crossed, put good energy out into the universe. Bitch, could you imagine me on television? Girl, like...
Girl, you are so fucking lucky that I got my hands on your phone and your laptop before your mom could, because bitch, let me tell you something. I mean, I knew you liked it freaky, but not that freaky, girl. Also, bitch, fuck you for leaving me here. Now I have to deal with all these stupid bitches by myself. You're not actually dead, are you? Well, if you are dead, I guess you wouldn't mind if I just checked your pulse really quickly. Damn, you really are fucking dead. Damn, girl, your nails look fucked up. Lucky for you, though, I did bring your favorite press on nails. You're welcome, girl. I wish you could see the new guy that I'm talking to in person. He is so cute and his voice is just so sexy, bitch.
Are you almost done?
No. Anyways, he has the most beautiful eyes.
How much longer are you gonna be?
Bitch, as long as I fucking want. I'm talking to my bestie, and if you interrupt me one more time, the next person who's gonna be in this fucking casket is you.
Damn, girl, who did your mom invite to your funeral? The people here have zero respect. Can you put in a good word for me with God? I've done a few questionable things in my day, and I don't really know if he's gonna let me into heaven. Do you think your mom would let me stuff you like a dead dog and put you in my apartment so I had someone to talk to? Yeah, no, probably not. Just so you know, your ex did show up about 20 minutes ago, and while he was at the casket paying respects, I did go outside and slash his tires. I got you, girl. I love you, girl. And don't worry, I will be seeing you soon. I give myself like 5 more years until I croak, and like 7 if I'm lucky.
So what are you gonna say at my funeral now that you've killed me?
He hasn't even texted me back in 3 days.
Really? What's the last thing you said to him?
I texted him, even though we've only known each other for 2 weeks, I think I'm falling in love with you. Do you think that was too much?
No, I don't think so.
What if he's just trying to figure out how to express over text how much he loves you?
You're so right.
So you remember that guy Chad I was telling you about?
Yeah.
Well, guess what he said to me today?
What did he say?
He said, "Can you please move your head? I can't see what the teacher is writing on the board."
He's so in love with you.
I know, right?
Like, why would he ask you to move your head in such a polite way if he wasn't?
Also, whenever we walk past each other in the hallway, he never looks at me, but always accidentally bumps my shoulder.
He's so subtle about his feelings for you. I love that.
Me too! So today when I went to the cafe, the barista literally asked for my name.
Really?
Yeah. And after he was done making my drink, he literally made eye contact with me and called my name so I would know that the drink he was putting down was mine.
Well, did you ask for his number?
No. Should I have?
Duh, he's clearly infatuated with you. I would even go as far as to say he wants to marry you.
Shit, I missed my chance.
Don't worry, bestie. There's always a next time.
I'm out of town, thuggin' with my round. My coochie pink, my booty hole brown. Where the niggas? I'm looking for the hoes.
Guess what I finally got in the mail, bitches? My ID!
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scram! So if you guys didn't know, I had my wallet stolen about 2 weeks ago after fighting an Irishman at the bar. Anyways, after I got my wallet stolen, I had to get a new ID and a new debit card. If you guys didn't know, when you're submitting the replacement ID form on the DMV website, it literally tells you it can take up to 4 to 6 weeks for your new ID to get to you. So about 3 days ago, I called the DMV and I was like, "Hey, I placed an order for a replacement ID. I have my order number right here. I was wondering if the order went through." The woman on the phone was like,
"Hi, I see here that it went through a few days ago, but unfortunately we can't track your ID, so expect to see it in 3 weeks.
When I heard that, I was happy, but I'm not gonna lie. I was also like,
damn, it's Pride Month, and by the time I get my ID, Pride Month will be over.
That also meant that I wouldn't be able to get into any bars or clubs. Lo and behold, I don't know if the woman on the phone meant to say 3 weeks or 3 days later,
because I literally got my ID today.
When I opened up the envelope from the DMV, I fully was not expecting to see my ID in the envelope. I thought it was just gonna be like an order confirmation thing, because I wasn't expecting to see my ID until July.
But look at me, bitches, I got my ID!
God is gracious, God is good, God is an ally!
Ally.
Amen.
Weird question, can you scream with me just a little bit?
What do you want me to say?
I don't know.
Say bitch, fuck you!
Say daddy.
Oh, like, wait. I wouldn't scream daddy, I would moan it, like.
Okay, can you moan daddy?
No, I guess you'll just have to see me after the parade and we'll find out what I can and cannot do.
Well, this is the part of the interview that we don't have on this platform. Find us on other platforms. Okay.
I think the lifeguard at the public pool has a crush on me.
What happened?
So you know how I can't swim, right?
Yeah.
Well, I accidentally got shoved into the deep end of the pool and started drowning.
Uh-huh.
And the lifeguard literally jumped into the pool, pulled me out, and gave me CPR.
No way!
Yeah, and instead of doing nothing, he literally went out of his way to save my life. Also, he did mouth to mouth.
So he made out with you.
Exactly!
He's so in love with you.
I know. I think one of the guys at the grocery store has a crush on me.
Why?
So today, while I was at the grocery store, I couldn't reach the paper towels on the top shelf.
Okay.
And one of the workers came over and grabbed them for me.
No way!
Yes way! And he was like, "Don't worry, ma'am, I got you."
Ma'am? Not I'm already giving you a cute couple nickname.
And people say chivalry is dead. Guess what Connor said to me in gym class today?
What did he say?
So we were playing volleyball, right?
Mm-hmm.
He was on the red team, I was on the blue team, and while we were playing, he spiked the ball.
This is getting juicy.
And as the ball slammed into my face, he said, "Watch out!"
Aw, that's so sweet.
Yeah.
You know what? I bet he spiked the ball in your face on purpose so he'd have an excuse to talk to you and say, "Watch out!"
You're so right.
It's simple. He don't like you. He don't call you. He don't like you. He don't keep his verb. He don't like you. He's inconsistent. He has someone else. He only calls you when he wants something. He's using you. He starts random arguments. He's cheating on you. He's not investing in you. You're not worth the investment. Never met his family. You're not the one. Been with your guy 5+ years, no ring, no marriage, he's still searching. You're a placeholder.
I never really thought I'd ever talk about this on TikTok, but I've always been really open with you guys, and I do want to take you on this journey with me. So, hi everyone, if you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch.
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So this might not seem like a long time to some of you, but I've officially been sober for 1 week. By the way, when I say sober, I'm referring to drinking. I don't necessarily know what switch flipped in my head. I just knew I had to make a change. And one of those changes did involve my drinking habits. Now, I'm not gonna say that I was an alcoholic, but I definitely will say that I have slash had a drinking problem. And I knew that if I kept drinking, that would be the path that I was going down on. I know I've made jokes and videos about how I am when I'm intoxicated, but those videos don't really encapsulate everything that happens when I drink, especially the days that follow and how absolutely horrible I feel. I think my issue stems from not knowing when to stop. Like, once I start drinking, it keeps going until the end of the night. And then with the days that follow, I feel gross, I feel depressed, I feel horrible. And I think my main problem started when I realized that drinking would also fix those things. It was almost like I would go out and drink with my friends for fun, and then I would drink to stop feeling depressed and gross. However, even though the first few days were hard, I haven't had any alcohol for 1 week as of 2 days ago, so Sunday. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm actually proud of myself, because I have tried to stop drinking before, and I would tell myself, oh, we'll go out and just not drink, and then I would go out and drink. So I've kind of just been staying to myself and not going out, just for now, so I don't have those temptations in my face. And I know a week doesn't seem like a lot of time, but if you knew how consistently I had been drinking, you would know that like a week for me is pretty good in my book. I love all of you. I'm so grateful that I'm able to be vulnerable with all of you online. And I just hope that by remaining consistent and not drinking, that I will notice a positive change and shift in my life. Love you!
Ooh, babe, you look rough. Is this what you meant when I would tell you a joke and you'd say, I'm dead as fuck? Because if that's the case, you look like a fucking mess. Who the fuck did your eyeshadow? That shit looks fucking crazy. Don't worry, girl. I brought some makeup remover, an eyeshadow palette, and 2 makeup brushes. Let's go. Tell me why that bitch Sarah, who literally stole your boyfriend, was posting on her Instagram story about you saying, fly high angel, rest in peace, as if she was actually your fucking friend. I posted too. Posted up at our house with a baseball bat. I wish you were still alive, girl, because your ex got a haircut and it is so fucking funny. Like, I wish you could laugh at him with me because he looks fucking scary, bitch.
Bitch, wake up! Wake up! You promised I would be the one who died first! Wake up!
Also, girl, you are so fucking lucky that I'm your bestie because your mom started asking me for the passwords to your iPhone and laptop after you died, and I just kept saying, I don't know. She definitely knows I'm lying, though. The people in line keep asking me when I'll be done paying my respects, and I feel so bad for them. I don't feel bad because they're crying. I feel bad because they should have gotten up here before me, because I don't plan on leaving your side until they're putting your casket 6 feet in the fucking ground. They can pay their respects in line. I hope you don't mind, but uni's kind of expensive, so I've been pretending to be a bouncer and making everyone that isn't your family pay $15 to get in here. And don't worry, girl, I will be with you very soon. I even bribed the graveyard workers to let me come into the cemetery during their after hours so I could chisel my name into your tombstone. I'll probably be with you in about 2 weeks. I just still am trying to figure out my plan on how I'm gonna myself, you know? Trust me when I say this, you'll never escape me, bitch.
Guys, I know it's supposed... Guys, I know it's supposed to be like hot girl summer, and I did believe I was ready for hot girl summer, but this summer, she snuck up on me, okay? I wasn't ready for it. So what if we all just agreed to settle for like a lukewarm girl summer? What do you guys say? Come on now, lukewarm girl summer 2023! We're not too hot, we're not too cold, we are just right.
And admit you're in danger.
Who are you talking to right now?
You know how there are certain things in the world that... You know how there are certain things in the world that you wish you could unsee? Like times you wish you could scrub your brain with a toothbrush so you could get rid of certain images you have in your mind?
Because I do!
And do you want to know... And do you want to know the image that keeps you playing in my head? Seeing a butt-ass naked 80-year-old man at the gym! Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So the other day I went to the gym, and when you first walk into my gym, I don't know why they have the layout like this, but when you first walk in, there's a little walkway. And to the left of that walkway is a sauna. The sauna in question, mind you, has a clear glass door. Tell me why, as I'm walking into the gym, I see an old man in the sauna standing at the door,
facing the hallway,
like this! Girl, when I tell you everything was out and hanging, I mean everything was out and most definitely hanging! I can't get it out of my head! And like, he had to have known that people were gonna see him.
Like, that has to be illegal.
Like, why are you just standing there with everything out in the open? And like, I'd get it if he had like a towel wrapped around him, or he was sitting far enough in the back so the steam would cover up everything. But when I tell you this man was literally standing right behind the sauna door, just letting everything hang loose. Ew. Like, bitch, I need a fucking lobotomy. Jesus Christ! Christ!
Guess who viewed my Instagram story?
Who?
Tom.
Really?
Yeah, and get this. He was the first person to view it, too.
He's so obsessed with you.
I know. He was probably, like, waiting for me to post.
Maybe that's his way of hitting on you.
Should I message him?
Duh.
What should I say?
Say, hey, I noticed you keep viewing my Instagram story. Why don't you just ask me out on a date already?
Okay, it's sent. Wait. He just blocked me.
He's probably just figuring out a way to message you back while also keeping you on your toes.
I'm so glad I have you as my voice of reason. During lunch today, Zach finally came up to me and started talking to me.
Really? What did he say?
He told me that making direct eye contact with him in chemistry class made him uncomfortable and that I should wipe my face because there was food all over it.
He's probably just uncomfortable because he doesn't know how to process his feelings for you yet.
Yeah, and if he didn't have feelings for me, he wouldn't tell me that I had food all over my face.
That's what I'm saying. How would he have even noticed the food on your face if he didn't notice the small things about you?
I never even thought of that.
I don't know what makes people feel so entitled,
but some of you bitches need to learn how to not be fucking dicks to healthcare workers.
Because for the first time in my life, I got yelled at by a middle-aged white man for sticking up for the girl he was yelling at the pharmacy.
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what
fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream! So today I went to CVS to pick up a prescription, and while I was in line, there was a gentleman in front of me. He goes up to the counter, and he mentions to the clerk that the medication he's picking up isn't for himself, but for his wife. Anyways, the person behind the counter, she gets him his medication, but one of the medications needed a prior authorization. This man started yelling at this poor girl, being like,
"It's the only thing all of you know how to do is waste my time."
And the clerk behind the counter was like,
"I'm sorry, but we're short-staffed today, and the only person that would be able to help you is the pharmacist. I'd help you, but I'm not a pharmacist. I'm still in pharmaceutical school."
The guy proceeds to say,
"Then where's a real pharmacist?"
And very politely, the girl behind the counter was like,
"She's on her lunch break, but she'll be back in 10 minutes.
This guy starts yelling at the top of his lungs, being like,
"You idiots keep wasting my time. Do any of you know how to do your actual job?"
So finally, I was like, "Hey, I know you love and care for your wife and you want to get your wife's medication, but yelling at these pharmacists after they've already done everything they can do for you isn't going to get you the medication any faster." This guy then looks at me and goes,
"Mind your fucking business!"
And then stormed out of the CVS like a little fucking bitch. But this is the kicker, okay? I then went up to the counter and I looked at the clerk and I was like, "I am so sorry he treated you that way." And she goes,
"This isn't the first time he's been here. He does it all the time. I don't care."
That wasn't the first fucking time, bitch! Bitch, if I see that man again, I am triple decking, uppercutting his bitch ass in the fucking jaw. I fucking can't stand people.
Put your money in the bag or I'm gonna have to kill you.
What? No, please don't.
Are you completely unfazed by the fact that I'm robbing you and threatening your life?
Yup.
Why?
That's why?
Not my bestie, you bitch!
What the fuck? Where did you come from?
Did you not just see me come through the window, you dumbass?
No, I did. I'm just confused.
Oh, you're confused? Well, let me catch you up to speed. You're trying to rob my bestie, and I'm here to tell you that's not gonna fucking happen.
Really? And what makes you so sure about that?
Well, for starters, you don't have a weapon.
That's a good point.
You also underestimate how badly I'm gonna whip your fucking ass!
Okay, slow down. I wasn't actually gonna hurt her. I just needed some money.
You're pathetic.
What a fucking loser.
Now apologize to my bestie.
Can I at least get like a dollar?
I said apologize, dipshit!
Okay, I'm sorry.
How much money do you have in that bag?
Like $20.
Give my bestie the bag.
But—
Now! Slowly. Now leave, bitch! Wanna go use that $20 to buy nail polish and give each other mani-pedis?
You literally read my mind.
Dick Rider! Dick Rider! Dick Rider! Dick Rider!
So if you guys didn't know, I went to Catholic school.
Shocker.
But while I was in Catholic school, I was an altar server. And to say the least,
I was really bad at it.
I've fallen asleep while altar serving. I've dropped the cross while altar serving, amongst other things. However, I wanted to share a story about how I once stopped and interrupted an entire mass because I decided to smash a bug on the wall with a handbell. The story begins on a Saturday night. I must have been like 11 or 12, but I was altar serving with my friend Diane. Diane and I were sitting in our seats on the altar in front of the entire church. Now, the priest was in the middle of speaking. He's talking out to the congregation. And while he was speaking, the church was dead fucking silent. Like, it was so silent, you could hear old people breathing. As our priest was speaking, though, Diane tapped my shoulder and then pointed out this big-ass bug on the wall. And we immediately started, like, squirming in our seats, trying to, like, inch our way away from the wall and the bug. No matter how far away we were scooching, it just kept following
following us, and look, I didn't know what to do. I was young and I panicked, okay? Lo and behold, in our church, we had a set of handbells. And you would ring the bells during certain songs like Gloria, Gloria, Glory in the highest. I could have grabbed anything, guys. I could have used my hand. I could have used a pamphlet. I could have used a book. But my first initial instinct was to grab the handbells. And bitch, I smacked the fuck out of this bug on the wall. But in doing so, it let out this massive ring throughout the church, literally echoing and reverberating off the walls. Our priest then turned around to make sure we were okay. And all our priest and the rest of the congregation saw was me with a set of bells in my hand and Diane laughing her ass off. Needless to say, my mother and Diane's mother did yell at both of us after church. And we were both removed from the altar serving schedule for like 2 weeks. I don't know what kind of sick trick the universe was playing on me this morning, but do you guys see anything off with this photo? Oh, you don't? Let me explain.
My right fucking pointer finger is swollen, bitch!
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So this morning, I woke up like usual. I walk into the bathroom. I go to get my meds from the medicine cabinet. Because if I didn't take my meds every morning, who knows what would happen?
Hey, it's Hannah. Hannah Baker.
But as I was opening my medicine cabinet, my pointer finger
was throbbing.
I don't know what demons I was fighting in my sleep. I don't know what positions I must have been in my sleep to cause my finger to bend backwards and snap. But I genuinely could not move my pointer finger this morning without wanting to scream in agonizing pain. My finger feels a lot better now than it did this morning, but it still hurts like a fucking bitch. By the way, I think it's a sprain because in middle school, I sprained my finger while riding a bike. Because midway through the bike ride, the seat on my bike was force feeding my ass crack my shorts. So I thought it would be a good idea to stand up while riding my bike and pull out the wedgie with one of my hands. But in doing so, I flipped over my handlebars and sprained my finger. However, this was a plausible situation as to how one could sprain their finger. But to sprain my finger in my fucking sleep, bitch! Yeah, no, that makes absolutely no fucking sense. And if any doctors on TikTok would care to explain, I would love to hear the reasoning behind why my right finger was swollen this morning.
Wait, so how does this work?
You walk over here. If you hear a ding, you get into heaven. If you don't, you go to hell.
Seems simple enough.
Okay, you first.
Okay.
We welcome you to heaven. Now you.
Okay. Wait, there has to be like some sort of mistake.
Well, it says here that you slashed the tires of your bestie's ex. It also says that you stapled another one of her exes to his bedroom ceiling.
Yeah, that one was funny. I like that one.
The list goes on. I'm sorry, but you're not welcome here.
But he did all of those things for me, and he did them with good intentions too. Yeah, I only did it because I'm protective.
I'm sorry, but these are the rules.
Well, what if I handed you a little something to get me into heaven?
Are you bribing me?
No, unless you want me to bribe you, which in that case, yes, I am bribing you.
Okay, yeah, send that one to hell.
Wait, no! If you send him to hell, I'm going with him!
What are you doing?
I'm good, remember? He can't just send me to hell. This has to work.
Okay, I hereby sentence you both to an eternity in hell.
What? Oh, wow. Wow, yeah, I didn't actually think he'd go through with that. Yeah, me neither. I'm sorry you did that for me. Judah, wait, Judah, is that Lady Gaga? Judah, maybe God Judah, did send us Judah, to the right place. Judah.
So if you guys didn't know, your bitch got invited to VidCon.
Again!
I have like no fucking words and I don't know what to say. Oh wait.
Yes, I do.
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is! It's time for the Daily Scream! So yes, I was given the privilege of being invited to VidCon my second year in a row. I'm actually surprised I got invited back this year because last year I went to every single booth at VidCon and tried convincing all the people there that I was Jeff Bezos' son. And at one point I tried convincing the people on the Amazon resting lounge that I was Jeff Bezos' son. But what I didn't know is they already fully knew who I was. So I spent a good like 20 to 30 minutes trying to convince the entire Amazon team that I was a Nepo baby with billions of dollars. And I did that for no reason. I remember growing up and seeing all these YouTubers YouTubers and Vine stars being invited to VidCon, and every single year I was like, bitch, I want that to be me. I want to be able to make people laugh, bring people joy, and then be able to meet those people. And guess what, bitch? Dreams really do come true! Last year I had so much fun meeting you guys and participating in the events that were being thrown. I also met SZA last year because I accidentally bumped into her in a random parking lot. So let's see what happens this year. I love you all, and if you can't afford it or you can't make it to VidCon, I understand. Cause babe, when I was younger, I couldn't afford it. But if you can't afford it and you are going, I'd love to see you and I can't wait to meet you guys.
Switching sides.
I wonder what our lives will look like in 60 years.
What do you mean?
I'm just thinking about what the future might have in store for us. Do you think we'll still be besties?
Duh! You can't get rid of me, bitch!
True. If we are still besties, I wonder what that'll be like.
Bestie! Bestie!
What?
Can you pass me the remote?
Bitch, it's right there!
But it's so far away.
It's literally right in front of you.
Please?
You lazy bitch.
Did you just call me a lazy bitch?
What? What do you mean? You know what? I think you need to get your hearing aids checked again.
So, what do you want to do tonight?
Let's go out and party.
We've talked about this. We can't go out. Our bodies aren't what they used to be.
Come on, it'll be fun. See? I still got the groove.
Come on now. Work, bestie. Work. Yes, workshop.
Yeah. Oh, I think I broke my hip again.
This is what I meant when I said our bodies weren't meant for partying.
Bitch, I don't give a fuck. Press the life alert button.
Can you say please?
Bitch, my hip is broken. Please press the life alert button.
Now, is that so hard?
This fucking bitch.
I have a date tonight with this really handsome gentleman.
I don't like him.
You haven't even met him.
Well, if he hurts you, I will find him and destroy his life.
How? You can't beat people up and run away like you used to.
I'll just bribe one of my grandkids with $20 and get them to do it. I've taught them how to pick locks, slash tires, you name it.
That's fair.
Well, whenever that time comes, I just hope you'll be there with me.
Trust me when I say this, I will be. And if I'm not, it's because I'm dead.
Miss Rabbit has fainted. Miss Rabbit has fainted again.
Here's a bright idea. If you say you want to hang and you're coming over, and then I get all fucking ready just for you to bail, maybe...
Don't agree to the fucking plans, bitch!
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So last night I was talking to my sneaky Link. And he was like,
hey, what are you doing tonight?
Obviously, I was like,
nothing. Do you want to come over and watch a movie?
And I know that you know that we all know that we sure as hell we're not watching a damn fucking movie. Lo and behold, I start getting ready. I shaved. I did my due diligence. And I've talked about this before, but preparing for the deed as a bottom is not a walk in the park. I have to take a bulb of water, shove it up there, make sure I'm clean. Then I have to shower, make sure I smell good. The list goes on, okay? Tell me why. As I texted him to come over, he literally sends me a message back saying,
sorry, I'm about to pass out.
Bitch, what? Excuse me, bitch! I just got ready and cleared out my entire colon just for you to tell me, sorry, I'm going to bed. Do you know the amount of work it took for me to get ready? All you had to do was shower and show up, and you couldn't even do that! So I literally got ready to get some last night just to get absolutely fucking nothing! The next time this happens to me, I need you all to know that you will see my face plastered all over the news with a sign right underneath my photo that says, wanted.
You know what I need right now in this moment of chaos? A cold cigarette to ease the pain.
Come on, answer the phone.
Hey, what's up?
We have an emergency.
What kind of emergency?
The code red kind.
How much time do we have?
An hour. Do you think you could get here before that?
Hello?
Why didn't you tell me sooner?
I panicked.
How long have you known?
About 4 hours, but I didn't actually expect both of them to agree to a date.
You mean to tell me you agreed to go on a date with two guys and you're just now telling me about it 4 hours later?
I know, I'm sorry, but what do I do?
Cancel one of the dates.
I can't.
Why not?
I've already canceled on both of them 2 times already, so it'll look suspicious. Besides, I like both of them, but I don't know which one I like more yet, and if I cancel on this third date, who knows if either of them will speak to me again.
Too bad you can't be in two places at once.
Or can I?
Why are you looking at me like that?
Well, you know how people say we look alike.
No.
Please, just this one time.
And how do you expect me to grow out my hair in 1 hour?
I think I have an idea. Are you gonna come in? Thank you, Sally Beauty Supply, for the gorgeous wig.
Now what?
You go on a date with Chad, I'll go on a date with Todd. Afterwards, we'll both come back here, debrief, and then decide which one I should stop seeing.
You owe me, bitch. Big time.
Trust me, I know.
Chad's here. You better get going. Also, please be nice to him. Don't interrogate him too much.
Yeah, I got it.
I love you.
Love you too, girl.
What the fuck? I blame Ice Spice.
Bitch, the demons I was fighting last night. Jesus fucking Christ. If any of you were ever thinking of taking edibles and then watching alien documentaries, let me save you some trouble by saying, don't fucking do it, bitch. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the deadly scream. So last night, I thought it would be fun to recreationally eat a cookie and then watch alien documentaries alone in my room. Never the fuck
again.
Bitch, the rabbit hole that shit sent me down is indescribable. By the way, when I say I was fighting demons, I mean I was fighting myself. I was fighting my innermost thoughts. I never thought I would have to say this out loud, but having an existential crisis under the influence is not something I would recommend for anyone. Like, I genuinely cannot put into words how I felt other than fucking crazy. I felt like a speck of dust in the cosmos. Like a grain of sand on the beach. And when I'm sober, that's an easy thing for me to think about or just like look over. But to actually think long and hard about that, to think that we aren't alone in the universe, to think that there are aliens already here on Earth and there are powers that are just unknown to us, to think all of that after eating a cookie. Girl, this is literally what I looked like last night laying in my bed. Bitch, I felt like I had sleep paralysis, but I was fully awake. There's no way, bitch, no. I am never doing that again. Don't do that. And if you do, do it at your own fucking risk, bitch.
Queen shit, bitch.
Hello, everyone. We are gathered here today to mourn the loss of my bestie, my number one supporter, and my ride or die bitch for life. Hey, girl! I see a lot of whack-ass bitches here who barely even knew my bestie, so let me quickly call out all of you wenches by name. Sarah, Jacqueline, Marissa, Faith, Debbie, and Lydia. All of you bitches can leave. The door is that way. Thank you. I also see Tom in the crowd, and I'm surprised to see you here, considering you cheated on my bestie 3 times. Tom, if you're here to ask for my bestie's forgiveness, let me speak on her behalf.
Fuck you, and maybe you should have apologized to her while she was still fucking breathing, you moron!
Also, I smashed your windshield with a baseball bat, so you might want to go run into the parking lot and check that out. Me and my bestie got into a lot of trouble together. Like that time we evaded the cops after kidnapping our ex, putting him in a barrel, and then pushing him down a steep hill. Or that time we snuck back into our house after we went to a wild frat party, and the cops showed up, so we had to sprint 3 miles barefoot to get back to her house. There were multiple times where we would tell her parents, we'll just be studying, but instead, we'd break into her parents' liquor cabinet and go on Omegle for fun. Regardless, this bitch is my day one. And if I could, I'd crawl on top of your dead body and be buried with you. Was that too much? Yeah, my bad, guys. Anyways, if you came up or plan on coming up to the casket to pay your respects and see any weird or strange marks on my bestie's body or face, it's because I tried performing CPR on her before any of you got here. I just didn't want to cancel out all hope of her not coming back. But when she didn't wake up, I did get mad and I smacked her. I didn't hit her out of anger, but in hopes that the shock of my hand striking her face would bring her back to life. Since that clearly didn't work, I got in contact with some sketchy local veterinarians, and they have agreed to put me down tonight so I can be with my bestie in heaven. So yes, this is my bestie's funeral, but I do expect all of you to be attending my funeral next week. Thank you and good day.
Guess where I am, everyone?
VidCon, bitch!
And guess fucking what, everyone? For the first time, the universe fucked up in my favor. The universe was on my side! And they accidentally mixed up my name in the hotel thing. I got 2 rooms, and I was able to get a suite! Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what
fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the deadly scream! So yeah, I'm at VidCon right now. Zaya's right here. Hey, girl. Anyways, while we were checking in, they basically told me at the front desk,
hey, so there are actually 2 rooms under your names. We made a mistake.
You have the option of choosing the regular room with 2 queen-size beds and a bathroom, or you can get the queen suite.
Bitch!
Obviously, I chose the queen suite! Let me give you guys a tour. Let me give you guys a fucking tour.
So you walk in, guys. Bitch, first of all, look at this.
A door to 2 beds. Emmy, Zaya, say hello.
I'm thick as I need it.
Then we have a fucking living room. A television, a little table, and then look at this bathroom, guys.
Like, you're kidding.
I've never been in, like, a suite before, so I feel so, like, bougie. And the fact that they did this on accident, too.
Bitch.
Like.
Spencer, hi, it's been so long.
Yes! Yeah, how are you? Yeah.
Oh my gosh, Zaya, I haven't seen you in forever.
Amber.
Hey.
You?
Hey.
Oh my gosh, Emmy, I haven't seen you in forever. How are things?
Spencer, oh my gosh, it's been so long. Hi.
Hey, gorgeous. How are you doing? It has been so long. I actually... Oh, gotta go. Sorry, guys. Oh my gosh, Zaya. Crazy seeing you here. How are you?
Hey, John. Bob. You? Hey.
Oh my gosh, Emmy. I didn't expect to see you here.
Oh my god. Oh my god. It's so good to see you. Oh my god.
I am sick of you bitches. Sick of you bitches.
I literally posted a TikTok
today.
And in said video, I included this photo from when I was in elementary school. It quite literally took you bitches 2.5 seconds to take that photo
and make it your fucking profile pictures.
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch.
It's time for the Daily Scream.
I'm sick of your shenanigans, bitch. I am sick of the shenanigans. I literally posted that video. I am not joking. 5 minutes later, I already saw the first profile picture. In my mind, I was like, no one else was gonna do it. I was proven wrong, bitch. This cannot go on. Guys, my mental health can only take so much at a time. And I'm not gonna lie. Yeah, I was a cute kid and I ate that picture up. But you're gonna use my buzz cut elementary school ass picture as your
profile picture?
Think twice, bitch. Think fucking twice. I have had enough. Guys, please spare me. Like, please, like this one time, I get it, but please.
You are a normal, regular civilian. Act like it.
Guys!
Please!
Enough is enough! I should have fucking known better. I should have fucking known better with you bitches. If you guys didn't know, I posted a video yesterday, and in said video, there was this photo of me in elementary school. And since, oh my god. And since posting that video, do you want to know what my comment section looks like?
You have got to be fucking kidding me, bitch.
I can't even open up my comment section without seeing my elementary buzz cut ass face as your fucking profile pictures. It does not stop. Like, it doesn't stop. I could scroll probably to the bottom of the comments. I would still see that photo. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream. Do you guys want to see me in a straight jacket? Do you want me to institutionalize myself? Because that's where this is going. I cannot go on like this. This is my fault. I should have known that there would be repercussions to me posting that fuck-ass video and using that fuck-ass picture. You guys are unbelievable. All I have to ask is why. Why? If you see me on the news with a muzzle on my face in a straitjacket in a padded room guarded by security, now you know why, bitch.
Now you know why.
Real, bitch. No, you're not gonna call me no bitch because I'm not none of these women. I'm gonna whoop your ass.
You guys are sick and fucking twisted. I posted another video the other day that included a photo of me when I was like 10. By the way, this is said photo. Obviously, it took you bitches 2.5 seconds to turn around and make that photo your profile pictures. That I'm not surprised about. What I am surprised about, though, is TikTok added a fucking strike to my account. And I got a notification saying that my account could potentially be banned because my video included the following three fucking pictures. One, two, three. That's right, everyone. TikTok sent me a notification threatening to ban my account because I had a photo of myself from when I was 10 and two fucking pictures
from Club Penguin.
It literally says violation reasons and then doesn't list any. Bitch, what? Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream. Guys, I don't know what the fuck TikTok is on, but my videos keep getting removed. I literally had a Daily Scream get removed the other day for harassment and bullying, and I wasn't even talking about anyone in the fucking video. I've also been noticing that a whole bunch of my videos from like 2 years ago have been getting removed, taken down, or just muted. And some of these videos were literally just of me doing those viral TikTok dances. With that being said though, bitch, I don't know what the fuck TikTok has going on right now, but if you see my account get removed, bitch, I don't know what I'm gonna do. Please just know that I do. I love you all so fucking much. At least we all know one thing. If my TikTok account gets banned, it's because I made a slideshow of Puffles from Club
Fucking Penguin.
Hello, everyone. We are gathered here today to mourn the loss of not just an incredible human being, but the realest bitch I have ever met in my life. I see a lot of people here today that rarely even knew or spoke to my bestie. And though I'm grateful that you're all here to pay your respects, I do want to say one thing. That thing is a promise. I promise each and every one of you wannabe bitches that if I catch you posting anything on your fucking stories, calling my bestie your friend,
when you barely gave her the time of fucking day? I will personally sneak into each and every one of your homes in the middle of the fucking night and bitch slap you in your sleep.
Anyways, my bestie, she was amazing. She really knew how to be there for me, comfort me, handle her liquor, and throw her ass back. I've only ever seen my bestie intoxicated one time. And to make a long story short, the night ended with her getting a permanent tramp stamp tattoo and then passing out in a bush. Now, before any of you approach the casket, I do want to say that I did chop off a chunk of my bestie's hair. So please don't be surprised if you see her with uneven bangs. I only did it because I always want to have a piece of her with me. I also put a walkie-talkie in her casket that I will politely ask all of you to not remove. I put the walkie-talkie in there just in case she isn't dead, wakes up 6 feet underground, and needs to get in contact with me to dig her up. I honestly don't know what I'm gonna do without her, but I always told her that the second she's dead, I am most likely going to follow in her footsteps. So I ask all of you that once you get home from this funeral, that you bring your dresses and your suits to the dry cleaner, because you can expect to be wearing it again within the next few days. Also, I don't know who was in charge of doing my bestie's makeup, but yes, I did redo it. I redid it because the person who originally did my bestie's makeup is fucking trash, and you should be fucking sued. Thank you all.
As many of you know, I had the privilege of being invited to VidCon this past weekend, where I got to meet so many amazing creators and so many of you guys. But what a lot of you don't know is that some of your favorite creators are
fucking assholes.
And I want to talk about it. Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So yes, I was at VidCon, and although I met a plethora of wonderful people, I also met a handful of fucking assholes. And just to clarify, the staff, the workers, the security, anybody who worked for VidCon, amazing people, loved them dearly. But it was the way that a lot of them were treated that pissed me off. At one point during my trip to VidCon, me and my friends decided to go to Downtown Disney. The gentleman that picked us up, he was really nice, but we were telling him that every single Uber or Lyft that we ordered kept canceling on us. He said that Ubers and Lyfts practically refused to go to the Hyatt Hotel, that's where the creators stay, and they refused to go there because of how rude some of the creators are. Some of the creators film their drivers, talk down on the drivers, leave trash and garbage in their cars. I was disgusted. Beyond that, I had a conversation with one of the employees at the Hyatt Hotel. She was a very kind woman. She was a part of room service. And the conversation started because she knocked on the door, asked if we needed anything, and I simply asked for garbage bags. She then asked me why I needed garbage bags, and I told her how me and my friends that I brought wanted to clean the hotel room before we left. And she then went on to hand me 3 garbage bags and said, "Thank you." And I was like, "You don't have to thank me." She then went on to tell me that some of the rooms that she goes into take several hours to clean. The furniture is all rearranged, stains on the carpets, couches, and beds. And that by us simply asking for garbage bags to clean our hotel room before we left was a blessing. I want to make something very clear. Your platform is a privilege. You are invited to stay at a hotel free of charge. The least you could do is clean up after yourselves and not leave a fucking mess. And lastly, if you were one of the people who were rude to, talked down on, or even filmed the drivers, you're pathetic. You should be thanking those people. And if anyone was at VidCon and had a negative experience with a creator, I am so sorry. I don't think I will ever be able to fully express in words how grateful and thankful I am for each and every fucking one of you and the opportunities that I have been given because of the platform you have all given me. I love you guys. I keep seeing videos like this all over my fucking For You page of people rolling glass down a staircase and then people duetting those videos trying to guess whether or not the glass will break. And while you're all concerned about whether or not this glass will shatter, I want to know who the fuck is cleaning the stairs between each take, because they deserve a round of a fucking applause. Every new take, the stairs are mysteriously clean again. Who is this person? Are they the same person who's filming the video? How long does it take to clean the stairs between each take? These are all the things I want to know.
Come on, just answer the damn phone.
Who are you calling?
You'll see.
Hey, what's up?
I wanted to talk to you about something.
Okay.
You know who I haven't heard from in a while?
Who?
Jennifer.
I knew you were gonna say that. You know what we need right now?
A debriefing.
Debriefing?
I am so glad you brought that up.
Do you always have to bust down the door?
Do you always have to look so fucking stupid?
Can you two just stop arguing for 1 second? We need to commence the debriefing.
Will someone please explain to me what a debrief is?
There are 2 kinds. We have debriefs after we hang out with a group of people.
For example, last week when we hung out with Sarah, Claire, and Catherine, we came back into my room, sat down, and then had a debrief session analyzing all of their actions.
And then there's the second kind of debrief.
The one where we both have an off feeling about someone, haven't said anything, but then we find out that the feelings that we have for that person are mutual, so we sit down and we look over evidence.
Okay, so you're talking shit.
No, talking shit implies making stuff up and judging someone's character for no reason. We have evidence to talk about a certain subject, and in this case, that subject is Jennifer.
Jennifer has been MIA for weeks.
Do you want to know who was supposed to be in that group hangout last week?
Who?
Jennifer. Do you think it's her boyfriend?
Duh.
She always does this. She gets into a relationship and then completely goes MIA.
Also, whenever she hangs out with us, he always has to be there.
And she acts like she doesn't see him every fucking day.
Also, did you see what she put in the group chat?
I was literally about to bring that up.
I feel like I'm interrupting something. Do you guys want me to leave?
I'm sorry, babe, but if you don't mind, could you?
It's just that the debrief is a critical component of any healthy friendship.
Yeah, we might be a while.
This gun isn't very edgy.
Something just happened.
I did this to myself. I did this to my fucking self,
bitch.
I have unintentionally made a cavalry consisting of individuals using photos of me from when I was 10 as their profile pictures.
This is fucking insanity.
Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome.
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch.
It's time for the Daily Scream.
So yeah, I literally cannot even look at my comments, let alone other creators' comments, without seeing my 10-year-old fucking face everywhere.
And there are literally accounts trying to see how many of my childhood pictures they can fit into one profile picture.
Beyond that, one of my mutuals, Kayla, posted a video the other day responding to a comment. And bitch, look at the commenter's profile picture. Now look a little closer.
Bitch, that's me. That's literally me from when I was like 9 or 10.
Even my mom messaged me the other day and she was like,
Spencer, why is your comment section filled with pictures I took of you in elementary school?
And mom, what can I say? My little kisses really know how to fuck shit up. Also guys, I was wondering if you were all okay with me calling you my little kisses. I came up with it because my username is Spencer, and contrary to popular belief, Wah isn't my last name. I just made my username by combining my name with the kissing Mwah sound. So I thought it would be fitting to call all of you my little kisses. And I think that's cute because it also reminds me of Hershey kisses. So yeah, tell me what you guys think.
But back to the issue at hand.
You guys are fucking diabolical. This right here, this is my villain origin story. And before anyone says shit, I know. I did it to myself. But beware, everyone, because this means war.
So I was thinking we could go on that hiking trail, and then after the hiking trail, we could go to the movies. What do you think?
Come down, let's do it.
Where did you come from?
I invited him.
Wait, you invited him to come over here?
Yeah.
I thought you two hated each other.
Oh yeah, no, trust me, we still do. His face makes me fucking sick.
Well, if you guys still hate each other, why did you invite him over?
Well, it's a mutual dislike. So even though we hate each other, we tolerate one another.
Yeah, picture us as like two negative signs. A negative and a negative makes a positive. And that positive is you.
We realize that we both love you. So for your sake, we've learned to tolerate one another's company.
Really?
Yeah, but it comes with a catch.
A catch?
I thought you agreed you wouldn't.
Whenever he says something stupid, I get to flick him on his forehead.
Look, I never once agreed to you doing anything like that. Ow!
See, he said something stupid, and then I flicked him on his forehead.
I'm just glad to see you two getting along. So we're all good for a hike and then the movies?
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Okay, then I'm gonna go get ready.
It pains me being nice to you.
You call that being nice? You just flicked my fucking forehead, you asshole.
Want me to start bitch slapping you again?
Yeah, that's what I fucking thought.
Quick question for all of you little fucking rascals!
Do you bitches get tired?
Do you?
Because I'm tired.
And you wanna know what I'm tired of?
The fucking shenanigans, bitch!
You guys wanna know what my comment section currently looks like right now? Let's take a look.
Oh wow, there's one profile picture of me. Oh, and look, another one, and a fucking another one!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new,
you know what fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
You bitches love to go above and beyond, don't you?
First with the Lana Del Rey edits,
and now this, bitch!
I can't even look at my mutuals comments without seeing my adolescent face as your fucking profile picture!
What is it you bitches want? Because I feel like I'm being taunted.
What are you guys doing?
Plotting and waiting for my demise?
Because if you are, why wait?
Just get it over with!
it! What are you waiting for?
As far as I'm concerned, this is where you bitches want to see me, and this is what you want to see me wearing. Is this what you all want? Because right now, institutionalizing myself feels like the only fucking option! What do you guys want? For me to surrender? Cause bitch, I surrender! I fucking surrender! What do I have to do to make it stop? Because at this point, I feel like the torment will never end. I told you we shouldn't be hiking after dark. We're almost back. We'll be fine. But what if something bad happens? Trust me, nothing bad is gonna happen. Whoa, what's that light? I don't know, but it keeps getting brighter. Where the fuck are we? Were we just abducted by a UFO?
Greetings, Earthlings.
Ah!
Calm down! I come in peace.
Peace? You just abducted us! I want to speak to my lawyer.
I'm only here to study your species.
Wait, so like, why us though? Is it because of how attractive we are? Or our sense of humor? Or our keen intelligence?
No, I abducted you two because you were the only two individuals alone by yourselves in the woods late at night, far from civilization.
Yeah, that seems like a plausible answer.
Yeah, that makes sense.
So what are you gonna do to us?
Kill you!
What?!
Nah, I'm just fucking with ya. I'm gonna show you a few things, you tell me what you think of them, and then I'll let you go.
Seems easy enough.
Number one.
Daddy.
Okay, now this one.
And be a better person. And this is something that I've always tried to do when I make mistakes, and it's something that I will continue to try to do. What? Oh, you don't care? Oh, okay. Thought you want me to take accountability.
Yikes.
And last but not least...
Wait, is that Earth? Are you gonna destroy the Earth?
No, sweetie, your species has already destroyed your planet. I'm just showing you what your planet is gonna look like when your grandchildren have to live here.
Our planet is so screwed.
Yep, it is. Well, it appears as though all my tests are done.
Not so fast. What do we get out of this?
The knowledge that your lives are futile, and I could kill you right now, but I'd rather watch the human race destroy its own species by killing the planet that you all call home.
Wait, no, take us with you, please!
Bye-bye now.
Wait, no, take us with you, please!
You bitches astound me. Like, I can't even be mad anymore. I'm just impressed. I want to show you all something. Can you see this right here? Let me zoom in a little closer so you can get a better look. This is a profile picture that was made up of a collage of my face. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream. You guys amaze me, like, every fucking day. You know, I counted how many pictures this person used to create their profile picture, and they used 26! 26 fucking pictures of me to make this fucking profile picture. Like, holy shit, guys. How much time do you have on your hands? Like, I can't even be mad at you guys anymore because what you have all taken upon yourselves is fucking impressive. The lengths you are all willing to go to.
Astounding.
I guess all I can really fucking say is, keep up the good work. Like, holy shit.
Hey, what's wrong?
Can you just come over? I don't want to be alone right now.
Of course.
Who do I have to fuck up?
I don't want you fucking up anyone.
Then can you tell me what happened?
Chad cheated on me and now he's going around school saying I'm a homewrecker.
Oh, sweetie. I'm sorry. Do you want me to grab you anything?
A water, if you can.
Yeah, of course. I'll be right back.
Hello? Bestie? Where the fuck did you go?
Hey, I'm back. Oh, wait, yeah, no, give me 1 second. Hey, I'm back.
Where did you go?
I went to pay Chad a little visit.
What did you do?
Why don't you check his Instagram story?
Hey everyone, I just wanted to come on here and tell all of you that everything I said was a lie.
What else, you freako?
And that I'm a baby bitch loser who only values women for their bodies.
Keep going, fuckface!
And that I have a really small wiener.
Now do what I told you to do.
Please don't make me.
Do it, bitch!
Well,
you didn't.
Oh, but I did.
I fucking love you.
I got you, girl. Now let me actually go get you water this time.
Thank you for everything.
You know I got you.
My eyes are literally swollen from how much I've been crying.
I just saw a post on my For You page of someone being like,
what if Grimace released his shake on his birthday so that everybody could be happy on his birthday? And his mom has to lie to him and be like, oh, sweetie, everybody loves it. When in reality, everyone is pretending to throw it up. Grimace just wanted to celebrate his fucking birthday, guys. And now I can't can't stop imagining Grimace inviting all of us to his birthday party and, like, nobody showing up. And he's like, Mommy, why didn't anybody come to my birthday party? And she's like, oh, it's because everyone's busy. It's okay, Grimace. Like, people just couldn't come. Why am I crying over a fictional fucking character? This is unfucking real. I'm sorry, Grimace. Happy fucking birthday. You deserve the best birthday in the entire fucking world. I need to see a fucking therapist. What the fuck, bitch? Ain't it fun living in that real world? So, who the fuck was gonna tell me that if I joined a public chat on Xbox, I'd be called a
fucking slur?
Cause last night I was playing Prop Hunt on Fortnite, joined the public chat, and within 10 minutes of me being in the public voice chat, I was called the F slur at least 15 fucking times. Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So last night, me and my friends were playing Fortnite, minding our own business, and I don't know why Fortnite does this, but at the beginning of each new round of a public game, it takes you out of the voice chat party channel and puts you into the voice chat public channel, meaning you're no longer just talking to your friends. Everybody playing the game can fucking hear you. I didn't know it fucking did this. So when the new game started and all my friends went to the party channel, I was yapping away at the fucking air thinking I was talking to my friends the entire goddamn time. Meanwhile, they couldn't even hear me. They were in the fucking party channel. And out of nowhere, I hear someone on the mic go, "Shut up, f-." And I was like,
what?
This random guy then went on to say, "You're a disappointment, and I'm sure your mom was disappointed when she had you too." He then said he wished he could see and meet me in person so he could my gay ass. And then some toddler hopped in and he was like,
"Yeah, but he said you gay fatty."
Like, some of you bitches have issues that you have got to deal with immediately. Like, I'm sorry, but how are you gonna call me a slur while playing Prop Hunt on Fortnite? Like, that's embarrassing, babe. I equate calling someone a slur on Fortnite to calling someone a slur at a G-rated movie. Like, it was never that deep. But I learned my lesson! Because holy fucking shit, that was terrifying. Xbox voice chat channels? I have no words. Like, holy shit, bitch. Never again. Never the fuck again.
What do you want to do today?
Want to go to the beach?
I don't know. I mean, I would, but I'm not really comfortable wearing a bathing suit right now.
Well, you wouldn't have that problem if you actually started going to the gym like I told you to.
What did you just say, bitch?
Where did you come from?
I was taking a nap in my bestie's ventilation system when I heard an eerie yet familiar voice say something fucking stupid. So I'm gonna ask you one more time. What the fuck did you just say, bitch?
I said that maybe she wouldn't be so insecure wearing a bathing suit if she started going to the gym like I told her to do.
Or maybe she wouldn't be so insecure if she didn't have an asshat like you telling her to go to the gym.
I just care about her health.
She is healthy, you dumb bitch.
Well, you wouldn't be saying that if you saw how much she's been eating.
Rest assured, if I had a boyfriend like you, I'd also need a 3-course meal to put up with your shit.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means she shouldn't have to constantly worry about you commenting on her body. It means that maybe the only reason she doesn't want to go to the beach isn't because she's uncomfortable with her body, but you've made her uncomfortable with her body.
Is that true?
I mean, it doesn't help when you're constantly making comments about my eating habits or me missing days at the gym.
I'm sorry, babe, but I stand by what I say. You'd look a lot better if you lost a few pounds.
I know a few she could lose.
Me too. And I'm looking at them. Are you talking about me?
Bestie, what do you think? You want to lose 165 pounds right now?
You know what? I think I do. Are you seriously breaking up with me right now?
Bestie, would you like to take the honors?
Yes. Yes, I would. Get the fuck out, bitch! You know what? Screw this.
You know what I could use right now?
What?
A family-sized pizza.
Me too, bestie. Me fucking too.
This whole Colleen situation, although it's a very serious subject and shouldn't be taken lightly, the content that has come out of it, fucking gold. Bitch, I was scrolling on my For You page. And tell me why, like, you know how, like, people's lives will pop up on your For You page? Well, the individual that I saw, they were playing Guitar Hero. And I was like, OMG, let me see what they're playing. And when I clicked on the live to see what the person was playing on Guitar Hero, do you want to know what I saw? They were trying to see how fast they could play Colleen 10 minute apology video. Not only that, but I've literally been seeing like so many videos about the situation. Kind of like this one.
I did not fuck those kids.
This is a cultural reset. Like, in 10 years from now, if my kids ask me about the 10 minute ukulele apology video, I'm gonna have flashbacks. You said it was true love, but wouldn't that be hard? You can't love anyone, cause that would be
Happy 4th, bitch.
If you thought I was celebrating the 4th of July this year, you were rudely mistaken.
What am I celebrating, bitch?
Because every year when I say that I don't celebrate the 4th of July, some bitch is always like,
that is so un-American of you. This is the day we got our freedom from Great Britain and our independence.
Bitch, shut the fuck up!
You wanna talk about freedoms and independence? Bitch, what the fuck is this? Employers, companies, jobs now have the right to discriminate against me because I have a little sugar in my tank? Because I'm a little fruity?
Bitch, fuck no!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know, fucking terminus, bitch!
It's time for the Daily
Scray!
Yeah, fuck it, I'm not celebrating the 4th of July. The only holiday I will be celebrating this month is my birthday, which is on July 23rd. Aside from that, yeah, am I gonna look at the pretty fireworks that are crackling and popping outside my fucking window? Sure. Am I maybe gonna drink a little? Sure. But am I doing those things because I'm a red-blooded American? Fuck. Fucking no. I'm doing it because it's the 4th of July and I fucking can. I do not see a reason to celebrate. Why am I going to celebrate independence and freedom when rights are being taken away from the LGBTQ plus community on a daily basis? If you see me celebrating today, just know that I'm celebrating because today is a great excuse to get fucked up. Aside from that, sorry to say, not celebrating for the USA. Love you all dearly though.
Man, I just shitted on them. Bitch, fuck the 4th of July. I'm here to get fucked up. Love the gays. I'm here for the gays because I am a gay. But I am not celebrating the 4th for the USA. I'm celebrating the 4th for the US gay. Man, I just shitted on them. Bitch, fuck the 4th of July. I'm here to get fucked up. Love the gays. I'm here for the gays because I am a gay. But I am not celebrating the 4th for the USA. I'm celebrating the 4th for the US gay.
I need a debriefing with all of you.
So yeah, yesterday I went out for the 4th of July.
And holy shit, bitch.
Maybe you saw it, maybe you didn't, but I uploaded this video.
Man, I just shitted on them. Bitch, fuck the 4th of July.
Let it be known that I don't remember recording that video, editing that video, uploading that video. So yeah, we have a lot to go over.
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily
Scrape!
So I'm just gonna start off by saying I had a little too much to drink yesterday. So I'm gonna tell you not what I remember, but what I was
told.
So everything was fine and dandy. Like, I was so fine. I don't know what shot threw me over the edge, but I ended up at my friend's apartment. It was like a few of us. And from what I was told, this is what I did at my friend's apartment. First up, I went around to everyone in the apartment and I said, guys, I need something to nibble on. And I was trying to bite everyone. Like, I was going up to people asking if I could bite them. One of my friends let me like nibble on their arm for 5 minutes. And then when I wanted to keep biting something, he let me nibble on his leg.
Just so you all know, I woke up this morning with this bite mark on my arm.
And I was like, what the fuck is that from? Bitch, I must have been nibbling on my own arm for who knows how fucking long. After that, my friend whose apartment I was at has a cat, so I put my head in the cat tower looking for the cat, then lied down facing up, and apparently I stuck my hand up and I was petting what I thought was the cat, and I was actually just laying on the floor with my head in a cat tower petting a fluffy cat toy for 10 minutes.
I wasn't even petting the fucking cat. Then I got up, stole someone's McDonald's,
and my friends kept asking me, like, Windsor, did you order that? And I was like, I don't really know. And I fully ate somebody else's McDonald's. I am so sorry. So yeah, that was my 4th of July. How was yours? You said it was true love, but wouldn't that be hard?
There's just something about eating the morning after drinking that makes everything taste so yummy and delicious. Bitch, you could give me a block of cheese on tree bark right now and I would eat that shit up. I would eat it, I would devour it, and it would taste fucking amazing, bitch.
People keep asking me to react to this Nair video by a guy named Kevin. I've been holding this off because I've seen a shit ton of people reacting to this video, and every reaction looks really scared or concerned, or they look disgusted. But let's jump right into this, bitch.
I'm putting my headphones in.
All right. You know how I know it's bad? It's literally asking me to log into my YouTube account because of age restrictions. All right, we're in, bitch. Let's do this.
This is how hairy my butt is right now.
I need a minute. No, absolutely fucking not, bitch.
Holy how is this video still up?
I just saw that within the first 4 fucking seconds. That's the first 4 seconds of the video. The first 4. It's just out. Why would any of you ask me to react to that video? Do you bitches have something against me? Like, I just saw directly into a grown man's hairy. No, nuh-uh. You bitches are fucked up.
Bitch, I'm sorry, but if you're gonna bring your adolescent kids to the movie theaters, the least you could do is teach them
to shut the fuck up while the movie is playing!
Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome!
If you're not new, you know what
fucking time it is, bitch!
It's time for the Daily Scream!
So yesterday I saw the movie Elemental and I need a debriefing with all of you.
First of all, if you went to go see Elemental yesterday and you heard a grown bitch crying in theater 13 row N, that grown bitch crying was me.
But that's not what I want to talk about!
I want to talk about the fucking families that were sitting directly in front of me during the movie.
You know when a family walks into a movie theater and you just know they're gonna be on some fuck shit?
Yeah, well imagine that times fucking two!
To begin, we're not even 5 minutes into the movie, and the kids in front of me who had to at least be 11 or 12 immediately started yapping the fuck away!
And their parents clearly didn't give a fuck because they started talking too!
And it took people shushing them about 10 times for them to actually shut the fuck up.
Like, I'm sorry, but if you're not here to watch the movie, then fucking leave!
Oh, but if you thought I was done, I'm not.
That wasn't even the worst fucking part.
I don't know if these kids and their parents wanted to play musical fucking chairs,
but every 10 fucking minutes, the motherfuckers would stand up, block the screen, and then switch seats!
Why, you may be asking yourself?
I don't fucking know!
What I do know, though, is that they were talking, standing up, walking around,
and pissing me the fuck off the entire goddamn movie!
And they were acting as if there wasn't a movie theater full of people
asking them to be quiet and sit down.
But you wanna know what's fucking crazy?
The only time these motherfuckers decided to shut up and stay in their seats
was during the goddamn credits, bitch!
Besides that, I loved Elemental, thought it was a great film, and I did cry several times. What about it, bitch?
So Instagram released Threads the other day, and I don't know who the PR person is for Threads, but I know they have Elon Musk shaking in his fucking boots, bitch.
Elon was going out and about saying,
cis and cisgender should be considered a slur.
Talking about how he wanted to make it a slur on Twitter, and then Instagram pops out of the fucking blue and they're like, hey, have you heard of Threads? I'm sorry, Elon, but the Instagram Meta team ate your ass up! Like, you placed the opportunity into their laps.
Like, Threads chewed up Elon and spit this bitch out. I just know yesterday, Elon Musk woke up, saw that Threads was trending on Twitter, and the bitch was gagged.
Anyways, this is my Threads account. You should, like, totally go follow it.
After that, I was thinking maybe we could go out to dinner, get some food, grab some drinks.
I mean, I'm down.
Oh my god, speaking of drinking, I really have to pee.
Oh my god, me too.
Let's go.
What kind of food are you craving? Because I've been really wanting some Italian food.
So, what time do you think we should start getting ready?
I was thinking, like, probably around 6.
Hold on. Are we not gonna talk about what you two just did?
Why do you wanna talk about us going pee, you weirdo?
No, not that. How you two literally just went to the bathroom together.
Oh, that?
What about it? Isn't that weird to you guys?
No, not really.
So you just pee in front of each other?
Yeah.
Don't you think that's a little gross?
No, we do it all the time.
Yeah, don't you ever wonder why when we're in public, we leave to go to the bathroom at the same time?
Do you guys go in the same cubicle when you pee?
Yeah.
Why? That's so weird.
Well, he comes with me because I ask him to.
Why do you ask him to?
Because, dipshit, we live in a world full of predators and scary misogynistic men, so having me or even another friend with her makes her feel more safe.
But you're both not out right now. Why did you go to the bathroom together if we're the only people here?
Oh, that's because we're just used to it.
Besides, we weren't done with our conversations, so we just took it to the bathroom.
I still don't get it.
You know how girls carry self-defense weapons when they go out?
Yeah.
Well, just in case anything happens, having your friends with you in the bathroom is like a self-defense weapon.
But what if you're in public and a woman asks you to leave the bathroom?
Well, that hasn't ever really happened because we usually just go into gender-neutral bathrooms, but if a woman voiced her concern, I would leave. I mean, I want to make sure my bestie is comfortable, but not at the expense of making another woman uncomfortable.
Oh, I think I get it now.
Okay, cool.
So where do you guys want to eat?
Bitch, you just asked us about pissing and now
now you want to change the subject to eating? And you called us gross for going to the bathroom together?
Fucking weirdo.
Unbelievable.
Thank you.
Shut up! Let's do this. You want all my head to
know? Oh, we can do it in the face and then we can go back to that.
Okay,
ready?
Are we doing pouty face now?
Yeah.
All right. Three, two, one. And one more. And
three. Are we smiling?
I don't care.
Smile.
All right, three, two, one.
If you have any stuff, feel free to drop it off on the thread.
That is so many. That is so many. Be safe, be healthy.
That's what time I was up until last night. 6 fucking a.m. And it wasn't because I wanted to pull an all-nighter. It was because my eyes were having an allergic reaction. My fucking neighbors were blasting their music. And a random fucking man outside my apartment was screaming at the fucking air. Hi, everyone. If you're new, welcome. If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream. All right, girlies, time for this fuck-ass debriefing. So last night, I hopped into bed around 10 p.m. I was snuggled up in my blankets, ready to go to sleep. And then I felt this sudden burning sensation on my eyelids. And I was like, what the fuck is going on, bitch? So I go into the bathroom, turn on the light, and this is what I see. Turns out I'm actually allergic to the eyelash serum I bought that's supposed to grow out my eyelashes. So I rinse off my eyes, I crawl back into bed, and all of a sudden my upstairs fucking neighbor thought it would be so fucking fun to play their music max volume with the bass all the way up. And when I tell you that the bass was so fucking high, my bed was shaking because my wall was shaking. Bitch, I thought there was an earthquake happening. This is what I looked like trying to fucking sleep. Finally, though, around 1 a.m., the motherfuckers turned off their god-awful music. And in my head, I was like, ugh, thank God I can finally sleep. Nope! Some man outside literally starts screaming at the top of his lungs. What he was screaming at?
I don't know.
It's L.A. He literally could have been screaming at anything. But that isn't what gets me. What gets me is the man stayed in the same spot screaming for 5 fucking hours until 6 fucking a.m. Lucky me, I finally got some fucking sleep. But I swear to God, if you're my neighbor and you see this video, I will personally hand your ass to you if I hear you blasting your fucking music until 1 in the morning again. And to the man outside, I don't know if you'll see this, but if you could fight your inner demons somewhere else, that'd be greatly appreciated.
Duh!
Duh!
Okay? Duh. You stupid fuck!
Train. Choking down the tracks of butt hair removal.
You've gotta be kidding me, bitch. Like, there's no way he's serious. Like, this cannot be true. 2023 is unfucking real! Wake me up from this fever dream now! What did we do to deserve this? So yesterday, I got trapped in an elevator for the first time in my life. I don't have actual proof that this happened, because instead of recording the situation, I was actually just fucking panicking and hyperventilating! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome! If you're not new, you know what fucking time it is, bitch! It's time for the Daily Scream! So yesterday night, I went to my friend's apartment complex because she was throwing a little get-together. I go into the complex, the people at the front desk literally just watch me walk to the elevators. And when I got to the elevator, there was also a group of girls waiting for the elevator. We get in, they press the floor they're going to. I press the floor to my friend's apartment. And as we're going up, I realize that the floor I'm trying to select won't fucking light up! The girls get out of the elevator. I am now in the elevator alone and literally just trying to click every fucking floor I can think of. I tried to open the doors, they wouldn't open, and nothing was lighting up. So at this point, I'm panicking because I'm thinking, well, I'm stuck in this bitch and I don't know how to get the fuck out. I'm looking for the goddamn call box to seek help.
Can't fucking find it anywhere.
I'm trying to call my friend in the elevator, but there's no fucking signal. I genuinely was like, I'm gonna starve and die in here. Lo and behold, 15 minutes go by of me being trapped in this elevator without being able to contact anyone. I'm still trying to figure out how to get the fuck out of there. And I feel the elevator start going down. And then I see the numbers on the elevator. They start going down too. This old lady, bless her fucking soul, she got home, clicked on the elevator, and the elevator took me back to the first floor to pick her up. So I get out of the elevator, I go to the front desk, and I was like, hi, I was just stuck in your elevator. I'm trying to get to my friend's apartment. And he goes,
Oh yeah, that happens. Unless you have a key fob, you can't press any of the buttons.
So why the fuck didn't you tell me that before I got in the goddamn fucking elevator?
Finally, the motherfuckers checked me in.
He sends me into the elevator and clicks on the correct floor.
But if it weren't for that old fucking lady getting home and pressing the elevator button,
who knows how long I would have been fucking stuck in there.
Like, you dumbass bitch, if you knew I could get stuck in there, why didn't you just stop me when I walked in, you bitch?
Duh.
Duh!
Okay. Duh. You stupid fuck!
You bitches are gonna call me crazy and I don't give a fuck!
But I'm pretty sure I saw visitors last night. That's right, bitch. I think I saw not one, not two, not three,
but a formation of UFOs!
And before you bitches start calling me delusional, just know I'm not the only fucking one that saw them! So last night I went to go pick up Emmy and Em from the airport. I'm driving them back home, and as I'm driving, we all noticed the same weird lights in the sky. At first, none of us said anything because we thought they were just planes, especially because we were still somewhat close to the airport. But the longer I was driving, we all noticed that these bright ass lights in the sky were not moving. So I look over at Emmy, who's in the passenger seat, and I'm like, girl, do you see that? And Emmy goes, yeah. And then Em was like, so we're all seeing the same thing? Immediately, we were all trying to come up with excuses as to why these bright ass lights were in the sky. First, we were saying maybe they were drones, but drones aren't that fucking bright. And these lights were bright. And then we were like, oh, maybe Beyonce's performing and it's just from the stadium. But it couldn't be Beyonce,
because she's in Canada.
We were all trying to narrow this shit down to what it could be, what it might be. And finally, we were all like, there's no fucking explanation. Those have to be UFOs. I'm gonna show you the picture Emmy took of them. This isn't the best quality, but I'm gonna try to explain. Do you see how they're all in this like triangular formation? Also, they weren't moving at all. And in these pictures, I know they look like stars, and someone's gonna be like, oh, those are just planets. Bitch, these were literally in the sky. They were too close to be a fucking star or a planet, bitch. So if we have any extraterrestrials coming down to greet us soon, let me be the first to say, hey girl, I come in peace.
No, please, not again.
As if you bitches using my elementary school photos as your profile pictures wasn't enough. Now I have to worry about this shit.
Will you still love me when I'm no longer young and beautiful?
No! Hi everyone, if you're new, welcome.
If you're not new, you know what
fucking time it is, bitch. It's time for the Daily Scream.
I was ambushed on my own fucking For You page. Like, I didn't even go to my tags and mentions to see that video.
I was jumped.
The fact that you bitches made a Young and Beautiful trend solely revolved around posting photos of me and ugly ass characters you claimed looked like me. Then there was a trend of you bitches taking my elementary school photos and making them your profile pictures.
And now. Now you're combining the two?
When will enough be enough? How did this even happen? Like, you bitches are little fucking rascals. I've pleaded with you. I begged on my hands and knees. I've even bargained with you, bitch.
Was none of that enough?
What is it that you all want from me? Because I can't keep going on like this. I've done everything I can, and it's just become very, very clear that you bitches want to see me locked away in solitary confinement.
What the fuck?
What the fuck was that about? I don't understand why you're making a big deal out of this. You introduced me to all of your friends as just your friend, and we've been dating for 2 months.
He did what?
What are you doing here?
I let myself in. I was gonna grab a few snacks and then leave, but what's a few snacks without free entertainment?
Look, babe, I didn't mean-
Oh, so now I'm babe? Because in front of your friend, you just kept calling me buddy.
Oh, no, he didn't.
Oh, but he did. And what do you have to say for yourself?
Can't you stay out of this?
And miss this? Hell no.
So what's the issue then?
There is no issue.
Sounds like there's an issue to me.
And what's the issue then?
The issue is you've been dating my bestie for 2 months, and instead of introducing her as your girlfriend, you introduced her as a girl who's your friend.
And?
Bitch, and?
Have you lost your damn mind?
Clearly. She isn't just your friend. Introducing her that way makes it sound like you only view her as someone you sleep with.
But she knows I don't feel that way.
Does she? And even if she did, it doesn't take away from the fact that you calling her a friend says otherwise.
What do you want me to do about it then?
You're gonna text your friends and say, hey guys, what do you think of my girlfriend?
Okay. If I had known that it would have affected you like this, I would have introduced you as my girlfriend from the beginning.
Now apologize to her, dipshit!
Okay, I'm sorry, babe. Do you forgive me?
Yeah, but that's a strike. Two more and you're out.
By the way, bestie, you might want to restock on some chips. You're out of them.
But I just bought a new bag yesterday.
Yes, and I finished it.
Wait, what?
See you guys later. Glad I was able to help.
If I was Olivia Rodrigo and I dated a guy with a neckbeard who looked like this, I'd write a song called Vampire about him too. Olivia, baby, I love you, but what were you thinking? Like, babe, the neckbeard should have been your first red flag. The next time you see a neckbeard on any man, run, bitch. Run for the fucking hills. But at least you got a bomb-ass song out of it.
Damn, bitch, you look great.
rough.
At least one good thing came out of you dying. Now I know I'll be having a closed casket service when I die. So you know how we always had a sneaking suspicion about Rebecca and your boyfriend Tommy? We were always like, why are they so close? Well, the second you croaked, those stupid ugly bitches got together. Don't worry though, I put Nair in Rebecca's shampoo bottle and released termites in Tommy's apartment. I hope Tommy has good luck sleeping after those termites bite away at his bed frame. I really want to see that new Barbie movie, but I don't want to go without you. So I ordered a life-size cardboard cutout of you. And don't worry, I already bought two tickets, one for me and one for you. Your mom's been asking me a lot of questions. Like why all the search history on your phone and laptop have been deleted. You're welcome. Or why every time we hung out, liquor would go missing from the liquor cabinet. I told her there was a ghost in your house, but I think she's on to me. Also, you know that shirt I've always loved and I thought went missing? Bitch, tell me why I found this in your closet. You're gonna have some explaining to do when I get up there.
Excuse me, how much longer are you gonna be?
As long as I want.
But you've been up here for 2 hours.
And if you keep talking, I'll be up here for another 2 hours.
That isn't fair.
You wanna know what isn't fair? That my bestie is dead. So unless you wanna swap places with her, I suggest you shut up. Damn, the people here really have no respect for the dead. Before I go, I just wanted to let you know that I built a tent right next to where they're gonna bury you. So guess what? We can still have sleepovers! I mean, I know I'll be the only one talking, but I'm sure you'll be there with me. I love you, girl. See you soon.
I told you guys this, but I was like fully in a car crash a few months ago. I might have told you, I might not have, I don't know. But apparently my friends took a picture of me after the car crash, and I didn't know that this picture existed until yesterday. Let me just show you guys this fucking photo. I look so fucking done. My face literally says it all. Look, guys, I've always been completely transparent with all of you, so I'm gonna be completely transparent with all of you right now as well. By the way, TikTok, this is for educational purposes.
I have gonorrhea.
It's the only STD I've ever contracted. I got it because the person I was with said they were using protection. I don't know when they stopped using it, and that's a whole other problem on its own. But the reason I'm making this video is because I feel a lot of people are ashamed when they find out that they've contracted an STD or an STI. When really, there's nothing to be ashamed of. As long as you're practicing safe intercourse, that's all that matters. Because contracting an STD is far more common than you probably think it is. However, if there is anything that I can say to motivate you to use protection, let it be this. A majority of the STDs you have a possibility of getting are treatable. However, as someone who has gonorrhea and got treated for it this morning, I want to tell you what that's like. Because let me tell you something, bitch, it is not fun. First of all, you have to get a shot. But the shot isn't in your arm, it's in your ass cheek. Now, aside from the fact that your doctor or nurse is going to have to inject the serum into your buttocks, the needle for the shot, he's fucking big. And that's the main reason why they can't inject the serum into your arm. On top of that, the serum that is used to cure gonorrhea is a pain in the ass, literally. When I tell you I have had plenty of shots in my day, but in terms of pain, the shot I received this morning, probably the most painful shot I've ever had in my life. And my ass is still sore. Now, why am I telling all of you this? Not because I want to scare you, but because I think it's important if you are sexually active that you use protection. Even though protection doesn't always work, you have a better chance of not contracting an STD when using protection. With that being said, I just want all of you to be well informed and know what you're getting yourself into if you aren't being careful. But if you contract an STD, don't be ashamed. Tell your doctor, get treated, because it's better to get treated early before your symptoms progress and get worse. Just know if you ever contract an STD, take a deep breath, go to the doctor, and I promise you, you will be okay. Love you guys.